Well, good morning, my friends, my family, my fellow bicycle gang. Well, it's morning here. It's pretty early here. It might be whatever time you're watching this. I had to come in pretty early this morning. I was laying in bed, and I realized something. We got in a bike yesterday. That's a rare occurrence, and it is a mountain bike. It is a mountain bike I have not covered before. It is also the first Bianchi that I have seen new in months. So I wanted to be able to at least show you guys what this thing is. I think it is Bianchi's kind of direct response to an entry-level machine like the Giant Talon. So let's jump to it. I will give you guys the weight. Stick around for that. I'm going to go through the specs. I'll give you two first impressions. One for the pandemic, COVID shortage times craziness that we're in right now. And if it was a normal year, what do I think about the bike? So let's just get to it. First things first, this is a Bianchi Duel. It is a large frame. They call it the 29.s. The frame is beautiful. I will say that. I really, really like this frame as far as the looks of it. I love the paint job that Bianchi chose for this. The bike looks way more expensive than it is. This thing retails at $850. Yes, $850. You do get these test ride pedals. I call them test ride pedals because that's about all they're good for. I would probably throw these away, buy something a little bit nicer. One thing I do really enjoy about this particular bike is that even at this price level, they do full Shimano. So you're getting a Shimano crank with this thing. You're getting Shimano rear derailleur, front derailleur. More importantly, Shimano brakes. You're also getting a Shimano shifter. So this is a 2x9 full Alivio from Shimano. Yes, shifters are Alivio. Front derailleur is an Altus. The brakes though, I'm really impressed that they actually put Shimano brakes on this sucker. They're nothing fancy. They're probably like the M445s, like a $50 retail brake, but still not terrible. So the bike is quick release, front and rear as well. You do get Shimano hubs, which is nice. They are laced up to some inexpensive Alex rims. They're nothing fancy, but they're nothing terrible. They're a pretty good bomb-proof wheel set. The last but not least, you get a SR Suntour front fork. The SR Suntour on this thing isn't anything fancy. It's a pogo stick, it's a spring. You're not gonna be able to change how much spring it really has besides preload. This is not a air fork. This is, for all intents and purposes, an entry-level mountain bike. You are gonna pay more. Well, I'm not gonna say that. You're not gonna pay more because it says Bianchi, but you're not gonna get as much. So I guess in a sense, you are gonna pay more because it's a Bianchi and they're not as big as Giant, but I digress. So my first impression of this mountain bike, is it worth the money? It's in stock. That's all you need to know. It's a large, but who cares? It's in stock. If you're 5 feet tall, you can make it work. It's in stock. We haven't had a mountain bike just on the floor that hasn't been pre-sold in a while. So to get this one in, and all jokes aside, like no, it's a mountain bike that's in stock. It is a large, so definitely you need to sit on it. Make sure that it fits you, but it's so hard to find a mountain bike right now. I would take just about anything. Pros of this bike. In my opinion, the frame is beautiful. I really, really like the frame. If inventory was correct, if I had this in my hand or like a Talon, the Talon's gonna be a better bang for your buck. Bianchi, you're gonna see a lot less of them on the trail. It's still gonna be a good bike for your money. You're not gonna hate this bike or anything, but you're not gonna get as much for it. The things that I would really wanna change at this price point though, you know, the Talon, around this price point, you start to get an air fork, which is nice, but I'm not gonna lie, the air fork on those Talons are still a very, very entry-level air fork. They still ride like garbage, in my opinion. So you're gonna be in the same boat. I don't even wanna say garbage, because when you compare them to like my bike that I'm currently riding, retails at like $4,000. So you're comparing two completely different things, or I'm comparing two completely different things. But that air fork doesn't ride, it's not head and shoulders above this thing. Now, what I do not like about this bike is it is a 2x9. This is a non-clutch rear derailleur, and the biggest downfall of all, this front crank, even though it's a Shimano, it's pinned together. This is not removable chain rings. Now you can buy a removable chain ring front crank That's a 104 BCD, relatively cheap. That's an upgrade I would do. And I would get a clutch, rear derailleur. I would put a 10 speed or 11 speed on this bike, but I would upgrade this thing to a 1x11 because for a beginner, which is who is typically gonna be buying this bike, a 1x setup is so much easier, so much less of a headache than trying to learn how to shift a front chain ring on your mountain bike. Because I do believe that if you're gonna continue to ride a mountain bike, you're gonna eventually upgrade to a 1x, no matter what mountain bike you get. Anything over $1,000 is gonna be a 1x. So I would definitely start looking at changing this out. The reason I say I'm disappointed that this is just a pinned front crank is because it's a Shimano crank, it's a double. I was hoping that this thing was just gonna have the removable chain rings and you could put a narrow wide chain ring on there for like $35 and you could upgrade the rear end of this bike to a 10 speed. You can get 10 speed stuff in a normal year, relatively cheap, and have a 1x setup. That's my biggest gripe with this bike, but all in all, I guess easiest way to describe it, and this is pretty true of a lot of Bianchi off-road stuff. This bike's kind of spec'd how the Talon would have been spec'd maybe 2 years ago. Granted, this is all new stuff. It's not old derailleurs and shifters, but a couple years ago, the Talon at this $800 to $900 price range did not have an air fork on it. It was a triple, I believe, maybe a double, you know, 9-speed bike. Now the new Talon for around $900 comes with an air fork, and I think it's a 1x9 as well. It's a little bit of give and take. To me, for under $1,000, you're still gonna be happy with this bike. It is a good entry level bike, and it is in stock. How about that? But the biggest thing that I can say about this thing for the price point, that's a beautiful frame. If I was buying between a Talon and this bike, I would solely be buying this one because of the frame. You could put the 1x on here, a nice fork. People would think that this was a high-end hardtail, or at least I would. I would also, come on guys, get this off of there. Like, I know that this is an entry-level bike, so the quick release makes it easy for people to get on and off of the bike, makes it easier to size, that kind of thing. If someone's gonna borrow the bike from you, it's an entry-level bike, I get it. Those quick releases never seem to hold. If people start riding this thing like they should, like, you know, a few times a week on a mountain bike trail, quick releases do not hold the seat post up as well as if you can torque down like a 4mm Allen key, and they tend to slip. I haven't found a quick release seat post binder yet that somebody that's normal weight, like 150 to 200 pounds, whatever, it's gonna make it drop. I recommend swapping this out. I know it does have an Allen key on the back to get it even tighter, but to me, when you start tightening that down enough to where you can't use this, that defeats the purpose. Other than that, beautiful bike. It is in stock. So let's throw it up in the stand and see how much it weighs. Let me give you a guess. I like playing the guessing game. What the heck? Whew. Right off the bat, 25 to 30 pounds. I don't know, every time I pick it up, it feels a little bit lighter. I'm gonna go with 28 pounds. Let's go with 28. I'm going to blame it on weight training. I'm getting stronger, so I definitely underestimated. This thing is 33 pounds out of the box, which I was gonna guess even before we started building it that it was gonna be around 30, because it's an entry-level hardtail, most of them around 30. That's pretty stout though. Couple more things that I did notice on this bike. One thing I do like, because it's entry level, everything's external, makes it easy to upgrade. I do need to put some clips on it. Like I said, we just built this thing, but all the cables are routed external. Positive side, if you're someone that wants to try to do your own cable routing, cable replacement, it's much easier to do it on an external bike. So bear that in mind.